mystery man came over and he said, "I'm out of sight." He said, "For a nominal service charge, I could reach Nirvana tonight. If I was ready, willing, and able to pay him his regular fee, he would drop all the rest of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me." But I said,
"Look here, brother, who you jiving with that cosmic debris?
Now who you jiving with that cosmic debris? Mystery man got nervous and he fidgeted around a bit. He reached in the pocket of his mystery robe and he whipped out a shaving kit. Now I thought it was a razor and a can of foaming goo, but he told me right then when the top popped open there was nothing his box won't do with the oil of Aphrodite and the dust of the Grand Wazoo. He said, "You might not believe this, little fellow, but it'll cure your asthma too." And I said,
"Look here, brother, who you dabbing with that cosmic debris?
Now what kind of a guru are you anyway? And ram it up your snout.
"But I got a crystal ball,"
he said, and held it to the light. So I snatched it all away from him, and I showed him how to do it right.
I wrapped a newspaper around my head so I looked like I was deep. I said some mumble jumble then, I told him he was going to sleep. I robbed his ring. Rocket rods and everything was about. I had that sucker hypnotized, he couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him his future then, as long as he was hanging around. I said,
"The price of meat has just gone up and your old lady has just gone down.
Now is that a real poncho or is that a Sears poncho? Don't you know you could make more money as a butcher? So don't you waste your time on me.